The evaporative control system is installed on Daytona 675s, which makes it US compliant. It's used as an emission tool to reduce fuel vapors from being released into the atmosphere from the fuel tank. The 11-ounce charcoal canister filters some of the vapors and returns it to the throttle bodies via some tubing and a valve to be burned later. I do not recommend doing this modification if you plan on riding in a street setting, because it's illegal. Furthermore, I'm demonstrating this modification on my track bike, which I seldomly ride on a closed course track. This is a very simple modification that should take you approximately 1 hour and remove 1.5 pounds of extra weight. I'll break it into two stages. The first stage removal can be accomplished by just removing the canister. Stage two removal will require some vacuum plugs, a resistor, two male electrical connectors, and some heat shrink, which will eliminate the entire system without a check engine light. So how does it work? When the bike is stationary and the engine is off, any pressure increase in the fuel tank due to a rise in ambient temperature will cause the fuel vapor to pass down the breather hose, which is attached to the bottom of the fuel tank, to a carbon-filled canister, which stores the vapor. Once in the canister, the vapor cannot enter the engine or be released to the atmosphere. When the engine is running, a vacuum is applied to the purge hose from the throttle bodies. At certain times, the ECM opens the purge valve, and the vacuum applied to the purge hose now begins to draw that stored vapor into the throttle bodies to be burned in the engine. In order to control the speed at which the vapor is purged from the canister, the engine management system shuttles the purge control valve between open and closed positions.